All across ocean and land, incumbent on all men, is the pilgrimage to Mecca, fifth pillar of Islam. In the footsteps of Muhammad, the last prophet of Allah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Welcome to Hajj Demystified, to explain the wisdom behind the things that are done in Hajj. Orders from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believers to submit themselves fully to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether they know the wisdom behind it or not, they would fully submit themselves because they know for sure with certainty that this is from the one that created them, the one that provides for them, and he's the most wise, and everything has a wisdom behind it. And all of these things done in Hajj is to establish the fear of Allah, to establish the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to purify the hearts by doing these physical actions according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered, following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the things that people do in Mina, when they stay in the days of a Tashriq, the 11th, the 12th, and for those who stay for the third day, the 13th. These are days that the Prophet ﷺ said about them, أَيَامُ مِنَا أَيَامُ أَكْلٍ وَشُرْبٍ وَذِكْرٍ لِلَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلٍ. The days of Mina are days of eating and drinking and dhikr and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ulama, they say, one of which is Ibn Rajab rahimahullah, he said there's great significance in mentioning these three things in this hadith. That the favors, the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the food and drink mentioned in the hadith, is to be used for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be used for the remembrance and the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what the people of in Mina they do. They eat, whether it's from their meat, you know, that they slaughtered. They drink what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it permissible for them, to be able to make more and more of the dhikr and the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which brings this concept of the relationship of how to use the ni'am, the bounties of Allah, the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to establish the purpose of our life, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. The favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are countless. Nobody can really count how many are they. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you count the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you won't be able to comprehend it and to count them. But what do we do then when we are ordered to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We are ordered to be grateful for every single bounty and favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on us. A human being cannot sustain that, is not able to do so. That means if we're constantly in every second of our life saying words of gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because the favors are endless, we won't still be able to fulfill the true gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His mercy, He made it easy for the believers. When a person wants to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just use these favors to be steadfast on the deen of Allah the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you, otherwise you're not grateful. So when we eat and drink, and this is a favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then we listen, we hear the adhan, and we don't go to make salah. We're not using the favors of Allah to establish the deen of Allah. We're doing the opposite. When a person eat and drink haram, from haram money, earning what is not permissible, he's not using the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's doing the opposite. When a person would have strength to harm others, to commit sins, to be forgetful, to waste one's life, right? This is all signs of being ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is mandatory for us to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how to be grateful to Allah? By following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The heart is grateful. The tongue is showing these signs of gratitude by making remembrance and dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the body physically is in state of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why these acts to be done in Mina shows this relationship. As the Prophet ﷺ mentioned it in the hadith. Days of eating and drinking and dhikr and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we look into our lives and taking this as an act of worship, that would make the person constantly in state of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is never to be forgetful when it comes to the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to redefine these favors, what is the best favor is the favor that a person is a Muslim. Nothing else is equal or even close to this favor. So if a person is given everything on the face of earth, wealth and health and all types of wealth and fame and beauty and everything, but he does not have the favor of the deen of Islam, that person has nothing, and it's worth nothing for that person. If a person, even if he's a Muslim and committing a sin that would bring all of these good things in this life for him, sin would give him more wealth and health and all kinds of things, but in the state of sin, all of these things has no value to it whatsoever. It will be source of regret for that person unless he repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the real favor is to be grateful to Allah, to be steadfast on the deen of Allah. And the believers, they need to witness that in their lives. They need to see clearly that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides His favors to them, some things might be withheld, some things might be given. But the real loss is when iman is being withheld. When the guidance to do the good deeds, a person is deprived from it. This is the real loss. And that's why the believers, they would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would provide for them the best of all provisions, and that is to be steadfast on the deen of Allah. In the days of Mina, the believers, they witness that. And they see that how the hearts can be deprived from making dhikr. A person wants to make dhikr, but he can't make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the days of Mina. He's deprived from it. And this is the real deprivation. And that's why when the believers, they would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help. They would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide them to make dhikr in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the sign that they are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to the food and drink that they have been provided for. When they see the favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on them, then the matter becomes easy for them. That they are so grateful that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the rituals for Hajj easy for them. The only thing that they do throughout the day after they finish the rituals of Hajj is to make the throwing of the pebbles and to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the dhikr is being mentioned again. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمْ مَنَاسِكَكُمْ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ الآيات. Which means that whenever you're done with your rituals of Hajj, and that refers to the days of Mina, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering the believers to make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the same way they remember their fathers and their forefathers. And among the people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the people are of two categories. A group of people, those who would say, "Oh Allah, give us the goodness of this life," and that's it. They are seeking the pleasure of this life. They're doing ibadah. They're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they're asking only from the favors of this life. And the other group, and these are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, they are the ones that would say, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. They would say, "Oh Allah, give us the goodness of this life and the goodness of the hereafter, and protect us and shield us from the hellfire." And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from the believers, and this is by the favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not order them just to ask for the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter, but out of His mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala, because we're weak, He ordered the believers and showed them that the best way is to ask for the goodness of this life and the goodness of the hereafter, and to be protected from the hellfire. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in these counted days of Ayyamut Tashriq in Mina, وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ, that make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these counted days. So the order has been repeated. And the believers, it's mentioned clearly that this is the days of dhikr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the eat and drink and enjoying themselves. And this is all by the favors of Allah. Then how can we develop this while the people in Ayyamul Tashriq? To make dhikr of Allah, the person needs to do two things. To make the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at specific times, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do so, like in the morning and in the evening. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to, whenever he would finish Salatul Fajr in the morning, he would sit in his place and he would make dhikr and remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till sunrise. And after sunrise, after that with some time, he would pray to Raka'a alayhi salatu wa salam or Salatul Duha. And the evening dhikr from after Asr to Maghrib, and if a person misses it, he can do it afterwards. So these are specific times where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say specific things and matters of dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To make remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at specific places, specific situations, specific times, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do that, and one of which is in Hajj, what to say when and so on. While throwing the pebbles, the dhikr is established there, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make dua after the throwing of the first pebble and the second one. He would make a long dua alayhi salatu wasalam, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his bounties. So the believers, they would do so. And they would make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these blessed days, and they would see that this is the best favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow on them. And then the dhikr at all times, sitting, standing, laying down, reading Quran, saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, enjoying the favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on them and their health. When a person is in pain and he only seeks the relief of this pain, he would think to himself, if I have health, I would use it for the worship of Allah. Which is easier for him to do that, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or to be in pain? But then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the strength and the health, then the forgetfulness of the heart comes in place. That's why in Hajj, we are taught to continue with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same way the person is grateful to Allah in the days of Ayyamul Tashriq. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are grateful and make remembrance of Allah at all times by the will of Allah, following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
All across ocean and land, incumbent on all men, is the pilgrimage to Mecca, fifth pillar of Islam. In the footsteps of Muhammad, the last prophet of Allah.